Hello friends, welcome back to Sojanya's English class. In our last class, we have learnt about infinitive phrases, and in today's class, we will learn about types of infinitives. So let us start today's session.
Our topic of the day is types of infinitives. Let's learn about them. There are three basic types of infinitives in English. They are full infinitive, bare infinitive, and split infinitive. Okay, let us learn their differences, how to identify them, how to use them in our vocabulary. Let's learn about it. First one is full infinitive. It is the most commonly used form of infinitive. Its structure is 2+V1. We all know that in our last class and the previous class as well, we have learned about it. 2+V1. To walk, to talk, to sing, to dance. It is used as a noun, an adjective, and an adverb in the sentence. And its structure is also very easy to remember, that is 2+V1. Look at the examples. He went there to dance. Here, why did he go there? In that way, it is modifying the verb went. Okay? So, to dance here is acting as an adverb. And then, he chose the theme to dance. He chose what sort of theme? He chose what sort of theme to dance, which is suitable for dancing. So here, to dance is acting as an adjective, which is modifying the noun, the theme. To win is the only passion he has. Something is the only passion he has. So all things by default are nouns. To win is the only passion he has. So here it is acting as a noun. The same about infinitive phrases as well. Let us see one example. To win the dance competition is the only passion he has. Something. What is that something? To win the dance competition. It may be any lengthy, it doesn't matter. But something is the only passion he has. In that way, it is justifying that it can act as a noun. And then bare infinitive. Here many students face difficulty, but it is okay. We will learn about it and we will use it correctly. Let us learn. It is an infinitive without to. Bare in the sense empty, vacant. Okay, what is it deprived of? It is deprived of its partner to. Okay, and then it has only V1. So it has only V1 without to. And then it is used after all modals except ought. Okay, ought by default has to use to. So bare infinitive doesn't fit in there. So all modals except ought use bare infinitive. You know what are modals? Can, could, will, would, shall, should, may, might, must, need, all those. Okay, and it is used after causative verbs. In one of my previous videos, I discussed causative verbs and explained them pretty clearly with lots of examples. If you want to learn about that, you can just watch that video. I'll try to give the link in the description box as well. So, it is used after causative verbs. What are they? Let, get, make, help, and have. Five causative verbs. So, all these five causative verbs use bare infinitive. It is used after verbs of perception like saw, watched, felt, and heard. It is used after some special expressions like had better and would rather. Had better and would rather. Okay, so this is about bare infinitive. First one is it is used after all modals except ought. It is used after causative verbs. And it is used after verbs of perception. And it is used after special expressions like had better and would rather. Bare infinitive with modals. Let's see some examples. We can complete the project. So here, You can see we can complete the project. Here can is modal and complete is our V1, that is bare infinitive without to. Okay, and then she might come after a month. She might is a modal and come is our bare infinitive here because we haven't used to before it. It's not 2 plus V1, it is simple V1, that's it. And then I dare not ask her permission. I dare not. This is modal and ask is our V1. I dare not ask her permission. So that is about modals. Now let us see some examples with causative verbs. Bare infinitive with causative verbs. I let is the causative verb. Let him do the work alone. Not to do the work alone. Simply do. Simply V1. Then she made them learn the concept. So here made is our causative verb and learn is our bare infinitive without to. Then we helped Sarah organize the house. Help is the causative verb and organize is our bare infinitive. That is simple V1. They had us request them for more time. Had is our causative verb and request is our V1, that is bare infinitive. He got me talk to the principal. Got here is the causative verb and talk is our bare infinitive without to. So that is a bare infinitive with modals and causative verbs. Now let us see some bare infinitives with verbs of perception. Example, I watched him leave the room quietly. Watch is our verb of perception and leave is our V1 here. What are verbs of perception, dear? I watched him leave the room quietly. The things that are perceived by our brain. Okay, then only they are called as verbs of perception. Perception in the sense receive or absorb. Okay, what are we receiving here? Our brain is receiving that action. Okay, I watched him leave the room quietly. So here watched is the verb of perception and leave is our bare infinitive without to. She heard him shout at his mom. Heard, that is also a verb of perception. She heard him shout at his mom. Okay, shout is our bare infinitive, a simple V1 here without to. He felt the guilt surround him at once. Felt is our verb of perception and surround is our V1 here. He felt the guilt surround him at once. Feeling, okay, that is also a verb of perception. She saw the thief jump over the wall. Saw is a verb of perception here and jump over is our V1, okay. It is a bare infinitive without to. And then let us see bare infinitive with some special expressions. Example, I would rather leave early today. Would rather is our special expression and leave is our V1, bare infinitive here. I would rather leave early today. Okay, and then she had better give us reason for going early. Had better is one such expression. Give is our V1 here, bare infinitive without to. So would rather and had better, these are our special expressions. He would rather wait before forming opinions. What do we mean by that? Would rather, what does it mean? In fact, it is better for him to wait. He should wait, that's what we are suggesting. Wait is our V1 here, bare infinitive. What is the sentence here? She had better give us reason for going early. What does it mean? She should explain us the reason for going early. We mean to say that, okay? These are some polite special expressions. I had better take his permission. So had better is our special expression followed by V1 take, bare infinitive. Okay? Hope it is clear so far. Now let us learn about some special sort of infinitive, that is split infinitive, which is very widely used in spoken form, but it is very wrong to use it in written form. That is the irony about it. Let us learn what it is. It is formed when we place an adverb or adverb phrase between 2 and V1. An adverb or an adverb phrase between 2 and V1. Let us see how to do that. It is used in informal situations, as I have told you just now. It is very much widely used in spoken English. Almost every day we use it, but only in informal situations, spoken, colloquial expression, okay? We shouldn't use it in formal writing because it is an example of bad grammar, okay? We should not let it happen. For example, she asked us to quickly walk. So here what happened, this quickly is our adverb which is placed between 2 and V1. She asked us to quickly walk. You might have heard such expressions in our day-to-day vocabulary. We do use it subconsciously. We don't feel that there is something wrong with this sentence. But grammatically, split infinitive is wrong. We should not use it in our formal writing at all. He urged us to sincerely read and top the test. So here you can see an adverbial phrased, sincerely read and top the test. Okay? Whereas our infinitive here is 2 and V1 top. These sentences can be revised as, first one, she asked us to walk quickly. Okay, so let us take this 2 plus V1 in a single segment. She asked us to walk quickly. Okay, so this is our adverb here which is placed after this infinitive 2 plus V1. In this way, the second sentence also can be revised as, he urged us to read and top the test sincerely. Okay, so here read and top, this entire phrase, okay, verb phrase is placed over immediately after 2. Okay, 2 plus V1s, both are V1s only, read and top. Okay, and the next rest of the phrase is placed after that. Okay, so in this way we are supposed to write our formal sentences. We are never supposed to use split infinitive in our formal writing. You have to keep this in mind very strictly because it displays bad grammar, as I have already told you, and we can't afford to let it happen in our formal writing especially. Okay, so this is what about split infinitive. Let us proceed to our quiz. This is our simple quiz. Identify the infinitives by their type as full or bare or split infinitive. Sentence number one, I am here to thoroughly teach you infinitives. Second one, we all want to sing. Next one, they made us wait for a long time. She invited him to talk. My parents will arrive here tomorrow. He went to his friend's house to study. She helped me clean the table. Our goal was to win. Okay, simple sentences. Just try to read them one more time and try to identify the type of the infinitive as full, bare or split infinitive. Okay, all the best guys.
So now we all know what is a full infinitive, bare infinitive and a split infinitive, right? Hope you don't use any split infinitives in your formal writing. And that's all for today's class. And in our next class, we are going to learn about actives and passives of infinitives. Till then, bye guys.